Land in Sarpy County, such as this land behind me, is prime for development, for homes and businesses. But there's an issue, of all things, sewage, as there's not enough sewer lines right now to handle that growth. But now, construction is underway in full force to bring in those sewer lines and potentially double the population in the county. Senators also redrew congressional maps, and you can see Nebraska's District 2 right here. But when you look a little bit closer at this cutoff line, you can see that it was drawn in a rural area where Congressman Don Bacon is building his new house, ensuring that the popular Republican can run for a seat again. Initially, the city of Lincoln is allowing for Canopy Street to have an SDL license about two-thirds of the Husker football game days, allowing fans to spread out onto the street and for just a lot more people to come to the area. But on days that they don't have the license, fans are confined to inside the walls of the rail yard. That's why on Monday, various bar management is going to the city of Lincoln, asking them to have fans out on Canopy Street every Husker football game day. Now, I was able to exchange texts with the owner of the grocery store, Tom Mulholland, and of course, he was more worried about the other businesses next to his grocery store getting hit than his own. Now, as for those other businesses, emergency management tells me it's unclear exactly how much damage there has been to them, although I will say just right now, fire department is throwing water on top of the business next to the grocery store. Let's of course hope that things are okay. Reporting in Malvern, John Kipper, 3 News Now. Currently the streetcar is just set to go east to west, starting on 10th Street downtown and going to 42nd Street in Midtown. But it may not just be staying that way. As Mayor Stotler says, due to the infrastructure bill passed by Congress, Omaha may be getting new funds to potentially take a north-south route, such as 24th Street, which is behind me. The roads right now are passable, they're usable. Wouldn't say it's an ideal driving situation by any means, but behind me right now is Highway 275. We're kind of between 120th and 132nd. So a lot of commuters trying to get home right now. And as you can likely tell behind me, they're going at a consistent speed. I would say people are going anywhere between 5 to 10 miles per hour slower. So kind of a wild and chaotic night. And right now downtown is completely dead. Police are banning people from walking downtown. It's very different than last night. We were stopped several times just to tell them that we were media before they let us continue to walk. So absolutely do not go downtown tonight because you very well could be apprehended. That's all I had for you, Jenny. Reporting in downtown Omaha, John Kipper, 3 News Now. When we got here earlier this afternoon, it was near the barricades all the way up there. And over the last few hours, it has slowly crept towards me. And as you can tell, it has certainly gone quite the distance. Yeah, Courtney, the bar does not deny that 6 minors drink on Christmas night. And I spoke to 10 former employees that say underage drinking occurred on more than just that one night. Kind of the calm before the storm right now, as behind me is the Embassy Suites. That's where candidate Republican Jim Pillen is going to be having his watch party tonight. And he's going to be at some other watch parties right next to him, other Republicans that have strong chances of winning tonight. Think Mike Flood running in District 1 for Congress. Think Mike Hillinger, the current Speaker of the Legislature, who's running for Attorney General. Now, in terms of what Jim Pillen has been running on, kind of his pitch to Nebraska voters, think many of the wedge issues that Republicans have been talking about over the last few years. So that's banning sex ed in Nebraska elementary schools. That's banning critical race theory, if it does exist, in schools all across Nebraska. That's fighting Joe Biden every step of the way, trying to stop his agenda from getting into Nebraska. And also typical Republican issues like fighting against abortion. And he's also talking about ending brain drain in Nebraska, bringing back Nebraska kids, getting them good jobs right here in the state. Will that message be enough to get him over the top, over Charles Herbster, over Brett Lindstrom? Time will tell. We should likely know, hopefully, at some point tonight. We should be able to get in the building by 6 p.m., get in the watch party, and have an idea of who's going to be there. And we'll have all the updates coming up for you later tonight at 6. Reporting in Lincoln, John Kipper, 3 News Now.